Hello everyone, welcome to the class. Children, today I have come up with the first poem, Pocket. So children, do you all have pockets for your dresses? Yes, we all will have pockets for our dresses. Especially boys, they will have pockets for all their dresses, right? So for girls, only for few dresses, girls will have pockets. So what are the things you'll keep in your pockets, children? So are pockets useful to you? Yes, pockets are very useful to us, right? So we can keep so many things in our pockets. Now what are the things you will keep in your pockets? So we keep like pencils, sharpeners, erasers, toys, small toys, right? Chocolates. So these are the things we keep in our pockets, right? They are very useful to us. We can walk freely by keeping the things, whatever we want, in our pocket, and we can walk freely without giving any pain to our hands, right? So pockets are very useful. And whenever we feel cold, what we will do? To make our hands warm, we keep our hands in our pockets so that after few minutes, our hands get warm, right? So it is useful to keep ourselves warm during winter season. Right, children? So here, Pocket, it is our first poem, which is written by an American poet and author by name C.J. Heck. So she is an American poet and author. She has written so many beautiful poems for children. She loves children, so she wrote so many poems for children, and she has published her book by name The Barking Spiders, where she has collected so many children poems and she has published the book Barking Spiders. And our poem, that is Pocket's poem, has been taken from the same book, that is The Barking Spiders. Okay, in this poem the author, she introduces a boy. She introduces a boy who tells that his pockets are his best. He loves his pocket more. Okay, so why? We will see in this poem. So he is the hero of our poem. He tells what are the things he keeps in his pocket. Ready, children? We told that what are the things we keep. Now we will read what our hero will keep in his pocket. Ready, children? Yes. The poem starts like this. I think of all the things I have, I like my pockets best. Pockets hold just everything and they give your hands a rest. I never know just what I'll find, what special things I'll see. To put inside my pockets, these are treasures just for me. When mom is doing laundry though, she says sometimes it's scary. Finding rocks and frogs and beetles and my spiders that are heavy. So now what our hero is telling? I think of all the things I have, I like my pockets best. Pockets hold just everything and they give your hands a rest. I never know just what I'll find, what special things I'll see. To put inside my pockets, these are treasures just for me. When mom is doing laundry though, she says sometimes it's scary. Finding rocks and frogs and beetles and my spiders that are hairy. So what the boy is telling in this poem? So I think of all the things I have, I like my pockets best. What he's telling, so when I think of all the things what I have with me, I feel my pockets are the best. Why? Because it can hold everything, right? So pockets hold just everything. Why he likes his pocket? Because it holds everything. And they give your hands a rest. So pockets, by holding everything, whatever we keep inside them, it holds everything and it gives rest for our hands, right? The pockets, they never say no. Will your pockets say no to you? No, right? So here also, the boy is telling, my pockets are the best. So it doesn't tell no to me and it just holds everything, whatever I keep inside in them. And they give my hands rest. Okay? Next, I never know just what I'll find, what special things I'll see. Now when I go out for a walk or for playing, I see so many things around me. And I feel some things are very special to look and by the color and by the shape. Okay, I feel some things are very special. So I'll put these things in my pocket where these are treasures just for me. So what he feels? So the special things, whatever he finds in the ground, he feels they are his treasures. So that he will pick them and he will keep in his pocket. When mom is doing laundry though, when my mother is taking my clothes for washing. Here laundry means clothes that will be taken for washing. Okay. So when my mother will take my clothes for washing, she says sometimes it's scary. Now what his mother will say? His mother will be very scared. Right? So his mother will say that she feels very scared to put her hand inside his pocket. So finding rocks and frogs and beetles and my spiders that are hairy. Now we came to know, right, what the boy is keeping in his pocket. What are the things he keeps? He keeps rocks, frogs, beetles and spiders. So all these things which he keeps in his pocket makes his mother scared to put her hand inside his pocket. Because these are very dangerous insects, right? The frog and the beetles. Beetles means the small insect which is like a cockroach. And spiders. Spiders also, they are very dangerous. So his mother is very scared because these things may bite her hand. Right? It might bite her hand and she may get hurt. So she is very scared to keep her hand inside his pocket to search for the things before taking for washing. Right, children? So I'll read the poem once again. I think of all the things I have, I like my pockets best. Pockets hold just everything and they give your hands a rest. I never know just what I'll find, what special things I'll see. To put inside my pocket, these are treasures just for me. When mom is doing laundry though, she says sometimes it's scary. Finding rocks and frogs and beetles and my spiders that are hairy. So children, I hope you have enjoyed this poem, right? So I have written few words and their meanings. Let's read them. Treasure. Treasure means valuable things. Treasure, valuable things. Laundry, clothes that are to be washed. Laundry, clothes that are to be washed. Beetle, an insect similar like a cockroach. Beetle, an insect similar like a cockroach. Children, in the next class, I'll come up with a new topic. Thank you, children.